Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. I'm with Oculus Rift Reviews. Today we're going to review and play Riff VR. Riff VR is a game, a music rhythm game on Steam for the HTC Vive, Oculus Rift, and Windows Mixed Reality. It's a music rhythm game that has drum simulation, karaoke, and a little guitar arcade game, mini game type. It's kind of like air guitar mixed with real guitar. I'm not going to show the guitar gameplay, but it's pretty weird. It's not really supposed to be a guitar simulation. It's mostly like air guitar simulation. It's hard to describe. I didn't like the gameplay, so I'm not going to show it. There's two things I do like about this game, which is the drum simulation and the karaoke. Now, the best thing about Riff VR is the licensed music soundtrack. It's amazing. And I bought this game on Early Access for $20 back in December of 2017. Today it's officially out on Steam, and the new price is $10, so they lowered the normal price, and it's on sale for $8. Now for $8, I think this game is an absolute steal considering the music soundtrack. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you, this is not the best drum simulation in VR. There's better drum simulation games out there, including Into the Rhythm, Drummer Talent, Drums Hero VR. Those are all much better drum simulation games in VR. So if you're looking for just drum simulation, don't care about the soundtrack, you should try those. But as far as licensed music soundtrack, this is the best game in VR, bar none. There's not even a close second. This is the best soundtrack in VR. There's not many options. The only options I saw was for streaming. I'm not going to talk too much about that. There's a creative hub. I'm not going to talk too much about that. I haven't spent any time with that. The one thing I do want to show is the profile, because you do change the look of your avatar in-game. You don't really get to see your avatar in-game, but for streaming, obviously, people are going to see it. And obviously, because I'm recording, you're going to see that as well. You can also change the guitar, but I like the guitar. I like Zach Wilde's guitar, so I'm going to keep that. So let's go ahead and play this game, because I don't want to make the video too long. Let's go ahead and start with drumming. And let's start. And I'm seated right now. I like to play seated, especially with a drum game, because obviously you're going to be seated when you're playing drum. So I'm going to have to lower the height a bit. And that might be a little too low. So one thing you have to do every time you start this game is reset the drums, which I don't like, or try to figure out the best position for this game. Now, I did notice that there are some mishits. I don't know if I can cause a mishit, but I have noticed it. And one thing for sure I do know is that there is a difference between velocity. So I'm going to go real soft. And so you notice the difference in volume? It's not a big difference, but I think you can tell. Okay, so there is a difference in velocity. I think there's only those two different sounds, though, either a softer sound or a louder sound. There are some mishits, though. I don't know if I can cause a mishit. I think I caused some mishits. Yeah, I'm causing some mishits right here. So it really depends on how you use the drums. As you can see, I'm causing some mishits. Causing some mishits. The other thing is, it doesn't, as far as your drumsticks, it doesn't matter whether you use one or two. So you see it's the same sound? Same sound, okay? So make sure you set up correctly. And also on the Oculus Rift, what you want to do is you want to lock. So what that does is if you hit the grab button by accident, you don't drop the drumsticks. Now your laser pointer also goes away at times. If you want to fix your laser pointer, if you're not seeing it, just teleport away and then you'll fix it. And I think I'm good right now. So let's go ahead and play a song. I like Tesla. So let's do Modern Day Cowboy on hard. I'm not a drummer, so I'm not very good. I do play guitar in real life, but I don't play drums. The only drums I played is in Rock Band, so I'm not a drummer. And as you can see, you see your buddies in front of you. Now, I'm streaming a different perspective than what you're seeing, a different perspective than what I'm seeing. So we have different perspectives. So I'll do my best. I'm sorry, I had to find the rhythm. Like I said, I'm not a drummer, so it does take me a little bit of while to find the rhythm. Now, you cannot play freestyle. If you play freestyle, you'll lose your combo points, so I can't do much with that. There's no crowd in this stadium. It's completely empty, so it does feel weird. So you're seeing a different perspective than I am. You have a camera that changes views. But I'm not seeing the same thing in my VR headset, so just be aware of that. Obviously I keep with a drummer point of view. My view doesn't change like yours is. I think if I was had the streaming option, I could set the camera to one camera only. Applause! Applause! Come on, cheer! Somebody! Yeah, there's no applause. You can see it's a completely empty TV area here. USA. Alright, yeah! Just imagine a big crowd cheering you on. That's what this game really is missing. You can see your bandmates, but You can't see a crowd. Obviously, you have a different perspective. You have a moving camera, but trust me, on my view. That's it. And there's my score. It says next stage unlocked. I don't know what that means. I've already unlocked everything. Now let's look at the karaoke. So I'm gonna slide my chair over there. I think I'm gonna stand up now for the karaoke. And let's go ahead and try the stadium for karaoke. I'm not gonna do the karaoke for too long because otherwise the review will be too long. As I mentioned, there's problems with the drums. It's not perfect. There's better drum simulations. The karaoke also has problems. You have a small screen, and you're gonna see that as soon as I move this mic here. Let's do a sound check. Sound check, sound check. So this is the screen that you read the text. It's very small. I'm gonna adjust the instrument volume to be a little bit higher, although you probably don't wanna hear me. And this is very clunky to use. And I'm gonna lower the, just a little bit. Okay, now I don't actually care about locking the microphone because there's no chance I'm gonna drop it because it's not, there's no way I'm gonna accidentally hit the grip button on the Oculus with the mic. And if you look all around, you see the little stage and whatnot. And if you look through the fog, through the crowd, you can see some hands moving. There's a lot of fog during the concert, but as you can see some hands waving, but that's it as far as seeing the crowd. So there's issues with the pointer going away. If I teleport, you might see it. There you go. See how I teleported away and I'm highlighting things, but the laser pointer is gone. With karaoke, it really doesn't matter because you only got to pick one song. So let's go ahead and pick a song real quick. Since I'm a 90s person, I'm going to choose a 90s song. I know the lyrics to these. I'm going to do Santa Monica by Everclear. So I apologize if anybody hates Everclear. I'm not a good singer, so I'm not going to sing for very long. I'm just to give you a taste. And I need some water, so apologies again for bad singing. I'm still living with your ghost, lonely and dreaming of the West Coast. I don't wanna be your downtown. I don't wanna be your stupid game. Put my big black boots in a suitcase. I do believe I found myself a new place. I don't wanna be the bad guy. I don't wanna do your cheap walk dance anymore. I just wanna see some palm trees. I will try to shake away this disease. We can live beside the ocean, leave it far behind. Live out past the breaker, watch the world die. We can live beside the ocean, leave the fire behind. Swim out past the breaker, watch the world die. Okay, that's all for my singing. I know I'm not a good singer, so let's go ahead and go back to the main menu area. You don't get any points for karaoke, so you can't unlock anything playing karaoke. You don't get any points or score. It doesn't tell you whether you're off pitch or not, so there's no score. It doesn't tell you whether you're off pitch, so basically you're just playing along to the music and seeing the lyrics in this small screen. I would like to see a big screen where you can read the lyrics at least. As I mentioned, several issues with this game. The laser pointer goes away often. And it didn't happen during my gameplay, but sometimes when I'm playing a song, it'll just stop in the middle. Like, it'll just exit the song for no reason. It does happen. It's happened to me, I believe, 2 to 3 times during my 3 hours plus of play. But despite all that, I do recommend this game. Like I said, it's only $10 normal price. It's on sale for $8 right now. And you have an amazing soundtrack. Again, you have Europe, you have Kiss, you have Night Ranger, Poison, Tesla, Three Doors Down, All American Rejects, Everclear, Fall Out Boy, Ex-Ambassadors, Marcy's Playground, Deep Blue Something, 38 Special, Grand Funk, Railroad, Joe Walsh, Leonard Skinner Music, Explosion, The James Gang, 38 Special, Hold On Loosely is one of my favorite songs. I also like Music Explosion, a little bit of soul, and almost all the 90s stuff I love. So I think for the soundtrack, you're getting a great deal for just $8, as long as you realize this is not the best music drum simulation game. I would call it a drumming arcade game, more in common with Rock Band 3. If you ever had Rock Band 3 and you had drums, you know that, you know, you had errors on that. It wasn't perfect. I don't know that if this is as good as Rock Band 3, but it's definitely kind of on that level, close enough. So I do like the soundtrack, but it's not the best drum simulation game. The karaoke could have done much better, and there's just several errors along the way, including the fact that you lose your laser pointer, and mid-song, sometimes it'll just quit on you, which is very frustrating. But I do recommend the game. I paid $20 for it, and I think it's a steal for the current sale price of $8. I'm Fast Lawyer, I'm with Oculus Rift Reviews. Thanks for watching, have a wonderful day, and rock on! Hell yeah!